Hello dear viewers, welcome back to Medchem Companion channel. Today in this session we will discuss the synthesis of Para-aminosalicylic acid has following structure. Now, how we can synthesize this drug, or what are the starting material, or from where we can start the synthesis? So definitely this amine group at the para position can be developed here by reduction of nitro group, and this functionality is your nothing but salicylic acid. This hydroxyl group can be generated here from amine moiety, or we can take anthranilic acid as an starting material. So how we can synthesize this drug from anthranilic acid? Let's discuss first. What will we do first is that we do the nitration in the presence of HNO3 and H2SO4. You know this reaction very well. So when nitration is done, the nitro group is added to the para position. So this is your amine moiety and this is your nitro group. Nitro group is attached to the para position. Now we know one reaction in which we can convert this amino group to alcoholic group directly by diazotization. So in the next step, what we will do? Diazotization in the presence of Na, NO2 and HCl, and after that we will do the hydrolysis in order to remove this diazo group with quite boiling. So what will happen? This amine group here gets converted into COOH, gets converted into hydroxyl group, and nitro group remains present at the para position. Now it is quite simple how you will convert this compound to the para amino salicylic acid. Very simple, because we need to reduce this group. So there are so many reducing agent available. So first we will do here with SYN-TNCl reduction. So what happened? This COOH group and OH, this NO2 group is converted into NH2. This is your para amino salicylic acid. This is your PAS, para amino salicylic acid. So in this way you can plan the synthesis of para amino salicylic acid. So there is another strategy, another method is available to synthesize this drug. The second method starts from nitrophenol. The second method starts from nitrophenol. So this is your nitrophenol. And we know very well a name reaction which is known by the name Kolbe-Schmitt carboxylation, in which we use what? Carbon dioxide at higher pressure and in the presence of potassium carbonate or ammonium carbonate. So what will happen? This Kolbe-Schmitt carboxylation is a method in which the carboxylation of ortho position of phenol group takes place. So Kolbe-Schmitt carboxylation method is nothing but by this method you can add carboxyl group directly to the ortho position of phenol functionality. So here this is the ortho position, so directly the carboxyl group is attached to this position and your following compound is obtained. Now it's very easy. Now what we have to do, only we have to do the reduction. So again SnHCl, in the presence of SnHCl you can do the reduction and finally you will get your compound COH, OH and NH2. This is your para amino salicylic acid. So these are the two simple method by which we can synthesize the para amino salicylic acid. Thank you.